So I'm Ashish, I'm from NetBrahma Studios. We disrupt with design. What we do strategy and design. I won't go too much into it, everyone knows about it. Quick story, what we have done, 9 years, 20 plus domains, 30 plus countries, 100 plus million users impacted, right? Straight to the project, we started with a company called Jigsaw Academy. They are into data analytics training platform online, right? And we'll see what we did for them. What are the goals, what are the process, and what is the outcome? Very interesting primary goals, identify user groups, establish trust, increase convenience, obviously conversions. We all need the money. Then educate clearly, right? What the company is trying to do and how they're trying to do. One big difference, their courses were $1,000 to $1,500, right? Unlike $10, $15, $20 courses that were available. So really a big, big shift from regular traditional companies that were offering that. Obviously a couple of secondary goals, reduce bounce rate, improve ROI, and so on and so forth. Interestingly, we also did user research. I'll talk a bit more about it. And when we did the user research, when we involved their existing customers and potential customers, we figured out there were only three primary goals that they were really interested in, right? And the first goal was, I want to learn, right? Knowledge, real deep knowledge. The second goal was, hey, I am a software engineer. Can I actually make a career switch? And how do I go about that, right? And the third goal was, can I get a certificate and get a promotion or a salary hike? Really, really deeper goals, right? Whereas the company really didn't look at this as a true goal, right? They usually said we're helping people move careers and so on and so forth, but not really as a promotion, as a certification, as a salary hike, which is a very, very deeper insight from user research. Detailed process, I'm just going to run really fast so that I can take you through more stuff. 40 plus users that we interviewed, card sorting, task analysis, user flows, prototype testing, heat test mapping, information architecture. I'll show you how we did data-driven information architecture versus gut feel, expert sort of an experience design. Obviously, very consistent web and mobile experience because most people would Google them, land up on their website through mobile, right? Obviously, a lot of interface design that we did, a lot of minimal design that still stands fresh even after the competition has done a lot more, right? This is our process, strategy plus design and the infinity in between, very, very homegrown. I tell people it cannot be two different things, but you have to do this continuously as designers, right? We were able to push this through to the client, fantastic guys. They were able to sort of help us, not push us back, right? Kudos to them to help us enable that. User research, like I said, we've spoke to 19 existing guys. I have not shown you photos, a lot of it is confidential, but I'm just giving you an overview on how we did it. So the goal was obviously to understand the real motivation and real frustrations, right? And like I mentioned, those were the three core goals that the users really had. Then we did interesting card sort experiments with them with both sets of groups. You all know about it. Then we actually bought out all the possible options on the entire web platform, website actually, that was available to them. We further broke them down and looked at how this data was getting mapped. And this was the magic, right? So we did a content proximity matrix that was led by our led by the partner at NetBrahma called Dimple, who heads our research. She actually led and helped us understand how users were looking at data and content versus how we were actually, as designers, pushing some of these interesting labels and beautiful terminologies, right? And this really, really set the ball rolling for the next phase of the project. So information architecture, for us, it was not just beautiful flows, right? It was about interaction and data as success paths. What is the success path for each of these users and their goals, right? And the goal was very clearly defined for a corporate customer, for a regular student who wants to learn, or a guy who is looking for a career switch. And all these success journeys ended at either he signing up for the course, or he giving us the details, or interacting and asking more questions, right? And when we knew these success paths, we were able to define different success journeys for different sorts of users. then integrate them back into one integrated information architecture, right? Obviously went through a lot of prototyping across web, tablet, mobile, right? So on and so forth. The end result, wonderful looking, great looking stuff, but that also actually really, really works. Now, one interesting thing that I want to highlight, in the first world, we have not sold a course, right? And that's very interesting because nobody buys a course worth $1,000 in the first world. His key understanding of the user was, you know, I need to either understand what the domain is, right? If I'm a guy who does not know what is analytics, I need to understand what the market is, what the job opportunities are, and how Jigsaw is going to help me, and then I can go on. But if I'm a little more informed guy, then I'm going to look at which course do I need to do, right? And that's, again, a very wide question. Out of 20, 25 courses, which is the path that is really, really for me? So if you see, there's an instant gratification called find my path. Within 3 seconds, with 3 questions, I'm able to do that, right? You'll see more stuff. I'm just showing you. This is the one, right? Within 3 seconds, you're able to quickly do the questions and go about it. Detail iconography, again, relating back to very, very technical topic, not generalizing, making sure they're really part of it. More interaction guideline, this was the output. I'll tell you more than this, actually this is the most important. They got a 500% jump in their conversions, 500% jump in their leads, right? That's massive. They got funded, they're doing really well. If you go to Google, you'll see really, really fantastic reviews, right? One quick.
I think NetDrama brings in a lot of rigor into the process. So it's not like you tell them, I want to build a website, and they go out and they build you a website. They do a lot of research in trying to understand what you need, a lot of experience within the NetDrama team. We got very good support from Ashish and the team, and all our questions were answered, all the concerns were answered, the response was very prompt. Yes, we have corporate clients as well, and a lot of corporates have reached out to us, and one of the things they tell us is that we have very good website. This is, I think, the fourth of
your plans.
Oh yeah, so like I said, right, we went with a very open mind of, we know these online users, we know how people buy courses, right? And the various obvious thing was, the popular courses have to be in the first fold. The goals of these users are to explore, show them testimonials, show them how great the company is. But we were actually wrong, right? Their core goals was actually, hey, I do not know anything about analytics. Can you please help me first understanding that? Can you help me switch my career? Which is a larger context compared to just doing a course, right? And so that was really, really powerful in the user research. We were really, you know, taken aback that, hey, we did not actually know the users. So that was a very insightful